Okay, so when it comes to decorating your lots, you just need to be creative. You can have as many or as few as you like. You don't have to even put any in. In fact, the last few times I've worn my lots, I don't think I've put any decorations in it at all, but I'm wearing a darker color this time, and I feel like we could do with something creative. So I'm gonna start with white and do something white quite high, maybe around about here, or maybe a little bit underneath actually. Here, we're gonna go here. We're gonna go second row front. But of course you do what you wanna do. So to wrap this one, I'm gonna do firstly a knot at the top, simply to get it to stay in place. And then I'm gonna wind with this one. You can do crisscross, but I'm gonna wind. I like the winded look, so we're gonna go ahead and just wrap. Just like you're wrapping extra hair around. And another knot for safety. Snip, snip. Oh yeah, I like that. So that's one done. Next color I'm gonna use green. I love green, so here we go. I'm gonna use some green on the opposite side. And I think I normally wear my hair flipped over, so you can take into consideration like where you flip your hair when you're thinking about where to put your ties, because I think one would look quite cute here, because if I'm flipping here, then I probably can probably go out here with the green, which is what I will do. And on this one I'm going to do slightly different. I'm going to do crisscross. So again, at the top you're going to do your knot. Okay, so that's not going anywhere. And instead of winding it around one way, we're gonna cross at the front, cross at the back, cross at the front, cross at the back. So we're gonna go, here's your lock, cross at the back, cross at the front, back, front. I've knotted that. I was going to plait it down. There's no point. Knotted. Right, so I've got 5 of the gold jewels, which I am going to put in. I'm going to put in all of the jewels. So I've got 5 gold jewels, 3 coloured jewels, and 2 shells. So I'm going to go ahead and put those in. Now, when I do my jewels, I always, for some reason, work off a middle parting. I'm going to try and get symmetry in there so that when you do wear them down, they're symmetrical at least. Kind of quite like them quite low down. So I always kind of try to match. I kind of try and make it a mirror, but that's just the way I do it. You do not have to do that if you don't want to at all. Thank you. So the newest addition to our kits are the shells, which you can see here. These are cowrie shells and they're easy enough to apply with a needle and thread. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and put in our first shell. And what you're going to need to do this is your needle and thread with quite a large knot placed in one end and your half shell. So go into the shell with the thread. Don't put it all the way through because obviously it's got nothing to secure it, so it'll just come straight out. And then go into your, continue through into the lock. Like so. Then we're gonna go ahead and knot off double, like that, and that's one half in. I'll do it again. That's one cowrie in. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and add my second shell. I'm gonna go for this lock and a bit further down, so around about here. So we're gonna go in to the shell. Right in, and then through. Yeah. Always keep your hangy bit because you're gonna want to loop into there twice. Done. And then you just cut your thread off. And these are my locks, decorated. And you can change it up, you can mix them up. Like if you feel like you've done it and you're like, a bit heavy around here, so I might take this one out. And then move it. You can play around with it. And I might decide to add the rest of my ties at a later stage. You don't have to do it all at once. You might want to just live with it for a little while and then be like, actually, I want more ties, or I want less ties, I don't want any ties, I want some new ties.